Zoey and Sassafras, Monsters and Mold, by Asia Citro, performed by Janina Edwards. Prologue. These days, my cat Sassafras and I are always desperately hoping we'll hear our barn doorbell. I know most people are excited to hear their doorbell ring. It might mean a present, or package delivery, or a friend showing up to play. Our doorbell is even more exciting than that, because it's a magic doorbell. When it rings, it means there's a magical animal waiting outside our barn, a magical animal who needs our help. My mom's been helping them basically her whole life, and now I get to help too. Chapter 1. The Bread Experiments.
Spork?
I laughed. The sound of the moldy bread squishing inside the Ziploc bag was super gross. So I poked the bag again.
Spork?
My cat jumped up on the table to see what I was doing. A cool breeze from the window ruffled his fluffy fur, and he squinted in the sunlight.
Spork?
He jumped backward and hissed. It's okay, Sassafras, I said, giggling and tickling his chin. The mold is sealed inside the bag. It won't get you, kitty. My cat didn't look convinced. It's actually really cool. I'm running two experiments with the old bread Mom found. See? I said, and pointed across the room. That experiment over there is testing whether wet bread molds faster than dry bread. I poked the bag on the table again. And this one is testing whether warm bread molts faster than cold bread. That's why it's here in the sun. Sassafras poked a toe at the bag and wrinkled his nose. There are other bags in the fridge and freezer, but they don't have any mold yet, which means this one is much more fun to look at. Don't you think, kitty? Sassafras scrunched up his face and jumped off the table. I guess he didn't enjoy these mold experiments as much as I did. Maybe he was too busy hoping the magic doorbell would ring. But ever since the sweet baby dragon I'd nursed back to health had left, the doorbell had been disappointingly silent. I was trying to fill my time with experiments to keep my mind busy. Working on science was way more fun than sitting outside my mom's office, waiting and waiting and waiting for the sound of the magic doorbell. I sighed. Outside the window, there was a rustling in the bushes. Sassafras leaped onto the table. He pointed his ears toward our backyard and held very still, listening. You heard that, right? I whispered to Sassafras. He meowed once in reply without taking his eyes off the yard. We both pressed our faces to the window screen. Maybe it was a deer? Or a cute little chipmunk? The bushes rustled again. Then something, or someone, cleared its throat. Sassafras and I jumped. Chapter 2. Pardon me. My heart pounded, and my stomach did flip-flops. I couldn't think of any forest animal that cleared its throat. My mom was out running errands. Should I get my dad? Maybe I just imagined that noise. I could think of one way to find out. Hello? Is someone out there? I squeaked. The shrubs parted, and a creature about the same size as me walked out. He was furry, orange, and had giant ears with two horns on top of his head. He squinted at me and Sassafras with his two big eyes. He looked like a monster. I stood there, frozen, with my mouth hanging open. The monster brushed his fur off and cleared his throat again. He seemed like he was about to say something. Could monsters talk? Sassafras broke the silence by launching out of my arms. Before I could stop him,
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.